this office. Wait. We're already here. Bamboozled again. So we don't need these around one. Hey, the thing. Not allowed to say hello to each other. I just get confused. Don't mind me. Here we go. Hey, cow. Good morning, Komaruk. Main character syndrome and assumes everyone is talking to him. My bad. What's the catch for this hunger deck? Well, it has a Jotun and a Glusty Warp in it, and a Ritual Sacrifice. I don't know, I wonder. I put that on the wrong row. Whoops. Hey, Han guy, gifting the sub to Shifty Looking Cow. Welcome. Wholesome Ratstorm. How about wholesome? It is Ratstorm. Just run this out. Whatever. This larva's gonna die, and that's fine. So the Skellige deck has the Raider dudes. 5 provision guys can damage rats on your own side of the board. Is there a cow? I see it. Oh, there's cow face too. Which has a lot of weird emotes. The Greatsword's at 9. It's gonna go to 10 as soon as I play a unit. This works, whatever. Charge? Yeah. What rank am I playing? Rank 1, like always. Yeah, it still takes. Cool. Now, round 3 might be a little too short. We'll see. top raider's target, Noonwraith. Ideally, this is what rank 1 is about. The best players are interested in competing for tournaments that get thousands of people in pro, just because it's the right thing to do. I mean, there is no real reason to stay rank 1. Unless you just don't want to play the format on pro. It's not like there's benefits to staying rank 1. Mulligan Operator. No, operators are our win condition. I mean, it's supposed to be our win condition. Surely we can draw one of our two Noonwraiths before the end of this game, right? There we go.
Women, children, elders, we spare none.
Can I bait that? If I show him the operator, he'll just sit on the raider ping. It's on the raider ping anyway. Okay, well, here we are. You can skjortle our beast now. Angry Witcher per rank is not much better than the rank 1 reward. No, but there is a reward, right? Like, per rank's just the natural progression from rank 1. It's a little weird because it's a completely different game, but why I don't use premium cards? I don't know, normal cards just look better. It's weird to see cards moving. Back in my day, cards were made of cardboard, and they didn't move around very much. Is he not killing the beast? He also clicked his raider. He didn't rain either? I'm so confused. I do like foils. It's rank 123 days into the season. What are my expectations? I've been near the other Noonwraith. Yeah, I probably should have. That would have made a little bit more sense. Enjoy being in a Discord chat with an opponent. For tournaments, yeah. I don't think that makes much sense for ladder, unfortunately. A little too much toxicity. Of mind games and stuff do you do with physical CCGs? All sorts of them. It's like half the fun. One of my favorites. I was dead on board on the bubble of a YCS. This isn't big enough, right? Oh. It is. Trusty Glusty. Yeah, I was on the bubble of a YCS. Okay, how do I explain this? Oh, chat knowing what cards do. There is a card in Yu-Gi-Oh! Called Starlight Road. Yeah, that card. Egyptian God card. I mean, I've only ever put Obelisk in a deck, so I guess it's that one. I've also lost more games to Obelisk than any of the others, so maybe that balances out. I don't need this round one. I don't need this round one. I don't want this round one. Why would there be a Danic Command? I don't remember Slayfer ever being playable. There were decks that couldn't kill an Obelisk, which made Obelisk good. Obelisk was a legitimate win condition for a while. Yeah, I don't think so. I don't think there's any that see any play at all now. Didn't respect Manticore though. Eh. He saw my username and knew that I would never play a Manticore in my deck. I respect it. Pretty sure it's not. Unless something crazy happened while I've been away from the game. Happens if we can't take round one. Yeah, we're a little sad. Did play a Lion Cadaver in pile. Fair enough. I have played some weird decks over the last 6 months. Heatwave would hurt now. I feel like if he had the Heatwave, he would have taken it on the haunt. I don't think that's something that I have to worry about at that point. More like 2 years. They've been extra weird the last few months. My standards as to what is a ladder deck and what is a viewer battle deck are, yeah. They don't exist. They're just the same thing. I guess I do this. I don't know. I want a Finn. I don't think I need all of my charges. I've got Karen. Oh, one of our big point cards is gonna get heat waved now, is it? Is it? We just win. Right? He can't do anything. There's some piles in the stream in beta too. Yeah. I don't think they were ever as bad as some of the recent piles though. Everything. I think this is everything. nice defender. No. Maybe he doesn't know. Stop hovering it. I had to make sure chat was aware of what was happening. Oh no. Seems to be aware. Yes. Don't get the rats over there. We're dead. Why eat the Noonwraiths? Because it makes him Burza his own board. And stuff like this can happen. You didn't. That matchup was absolutely impossible. Needed to, like, never draw Reinforced Trebuchet. That was one of the things that held this deck back right after the release of Noonwraith. It just had so many bad matchups.
These are the words of scripture.
Does a fine job of holding itself back? True, but like, the deck was... The deck has gotten better with time. It was really bad when it first came out, by no fault of its own. Just the strategy that it was trying to execute wasn't good against anything. Just pass. You're not beating double Larva Haunt. You're gonna try though. I'm happy to play this. I very easily got the reach with Foglet, right? Rats, rats, we'll give him some rats. I don't know if we actually beat Bone Talisman decks, but we're gonna try. Cause like Lusty Warp's dead, right? I don't think the bleed is ever good for us. Draw it, it's fine. Hey, Lion. We were playing Kelly 2 days ago. What do you mean, finally? Play a lot of spicy decks. I'm missing Lusty, but I don't think Lusty is good. I don't know. Does it remind you of Alessio crying? There's no way we have enough points. Yeah, there's a lot of problems here. I think our current theory is just on the Detlaff. Nah, we're the ones spawning it. Okay, I just need him to have nothing. So we need to play to Brick Diazire. Play around Heat Wave. Mirror is mostly here for round one. It's really good for winning round one. Yeah, I'll try to be careful of Tavern Brawl. Yeah, I could just run the Yoden out early. I lose a lot of points if I don't, and I probably need the points. If he's got Heat Wave, he's got Heat Wave. He didn't gun Bone Talisman, which is a good sign, maybe? We do have the same rough color palette. This is the kind of thing that I would do. Wait, what cat season bug?
Such a shame, I must kill you.
So I'm gonna play this first to play around the Azire, since if I go Corinthier, Leader Charge, Detlaff, the Ekimar is a 3. Kill Maruna and open up row space. Then I just consume a Noonwraith, right? Isn't that fine? Go in card back menu, in match setup.
Will you learn from that blunder? Are you capable?
There's a better way to explain that. Yeah. We figured it out. It's okay. We are Pavkos? I don't know if we are Pavkos. It's okay. We got there in the end. That's all that matters. So I'm gonna go Larva, he's gonna go Glusty, and I'm going to be sad. He's thinking about it. No, okay. Point of that, playing both larvas to bait out his Glusty. Open the tree that is not available now. This would probably make a lot more sense if I have ever interacted with the reward tree before. Like, I wouldn't know what I'm looking at. Would you like to pass? Playing Rat Swarm, we are. It will be a nice glossy. Boom, talisman time. Four, 5, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Yeah, we just like get him with Glusty Warp. I did get his leader. Let's see what he does. This might not be a Rat Swarm game, and that might just be okay. Also, how did we queue into two Bone Talisman decks in a row while playing Glusty? It's messed up. I'm just gonna give me a Jotun by themselves, right? There's a weekly quest to win 2 matches without killing units. Wait, really? And then we're just gravitating towards Bone Talisman decks? There's a Parasite in his list, though. Yep, Glusty also destroys damaged units at 1. I mean, he's gonna get a Noonwraith next turn. This might be too greedy, I don't know. If I eat the eggs, I get more points on the Glusty, but I'm weaker to like a heat wave. I think I'm okay just doing this. It's only 3 extra points, and it's 3 extra points with really bad distribution. I'd be sad if he's got Glusty. Okay. My swarm deck? I don't think so. I don't think I was playing Clear Skies recently. Save one charge. I'll respect Heat Wave a bit. Cool. Yeah, pivoting off of the rat's plan makes a lot of sense once you see Fierce Skies. Some cards that didn't fulfill their primary purpose, but found use anyway. Like the Jotun. Yeah, the AQ deck was tough. That's true. Red Aranan. New player to play Syndicate? I didn't tell a new player to play Syndicate. What? Someone asked what the hardest deck was. I was answering them. Choose not to play in Pro Ladder. I don't enjoy playing with hidden usernames. That's the serious answer. The pre-made decks, not worth getting them. I don't know what's in them. Chat'll probably be more informed than I am. Hey, Winky the Elf. How you doing? I know what's in the Syndicate one, at least. I don't remember what's in the Syndicate one. TLG has a good beginner's guide to keep updated. Whatever. It gets me out, right? Hopefully, there is no Pavko. Yes, faction cakes have all the expansions. Operator Ritzak. Marina's kind of bad in this matchup, right? So we're not operatoring?
'Tis my tree. I was born with it. I shall die with it.
Jaylee. He's not getting units down well, he can. I'm gonna be a Noonwraith short. I need a operator.
Wait, yes, they won't let us talk to strangers.
This is good for us though. Oh. Okay. That's a lot of space. He's got one space left over. So his Call of the Forest is bricked. Are on your end. Might have been frames. I dropped a couple. Not sure when that happened. Seems to be okay now. Well, that tutor's not bricked. Okay, what do you got? Boosting the rats? I don't know. Oh, true. They got an extra point, assuming the Karen. No, there's no more tire.
Ested essa crisa.
So, Viso kind of beats us. Also don't have the round one haunt. Or a Detlaf, you can like commit leader charges to win. This is gonna be rough. The deck we are currently playing is Oh, it's not quite this. I had to cut the penitent package. But that's the idea. I'll try to share the exact list after this game. I think I cut the penitent and the Pugo for Goliath and before Picard? Yeah. It was Goliath and a Noonwraith. Burberry ad again? Tell us about it. What was it? What's Burberry?
Scrub this, scrub that for the sake of sick of these chills.
Burberry is a fashion brand? Oh, why are they advertising on Twitch? Twitch viewers don't leave their houses. What do they need fashion for? Well, I'm gonna pass here, and I'm going to be sad, I think. Yeah. This is what? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? I guess I can do this. Except I don't get the tokens. Hopefully we're still okay. One of these days, I'll get used to it. I know how it works when I'm playing Kiki. I just don't think about it when I'm not playing Kiki. What is going on in my Discord? Not seeing anything. General, 6 days ago. Right. Maybe he'll just take the long round. I'll take the dry pass with Noonwraith. And then we'll, Yeah, this is okay. This is definitely winnable. Bit of a downgrade. This makes my Jotun bad, but... Yeah, I don't know if there's a world where this is ever winning. Some glusty too. Using Ritzak Operator Glusty. I'm just going for points. So, 1, 2, 3. We got a Karen. Just not consume with the Vargas. Awaiting your orders. Maybe his cards are really bad. We may have found the universe where this game was winnable. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. I don't think it's worth getting a couple points on the Jotun playing harder into the Anseis. So I guess that's that, and then this. Maybe? I mean, he's got Varaxis on, say, Shield Wall. AA? That's not very good. I don't think Double Tall Removal wins here, does it? 17 plus 10? Win by 2. Good shit. We found the universe! Or our opponent bricks just as hard as we did. That was like plan E from both of us. Double larva again. White Frost is fine, right? You can't do anything about rats as long as we win round one. And don't brick. change the cam? No. Now we just gotta draw a rat combo. That's part of it. Nope. It's done over committing. I mean, we kinda committed a similar amount, right? So I played both larvas and haunt. He played one larva, Aridin Goliath, and pulled his Winter Queen. Like, sort of depends just how valuable you think Haunt is, but, like, Haunt for Arid and Winter Queen doesn't seem that bad. Nothing but a skin. Their hair, so silky. So I'm missing Yolton. That should be fine. I can Aniro for that one and just have three Noonwraiths. The current theory down here, he can't move the Noonwraith into a frost. I'm letting him Ardgef me now. I don't know. Jig is up. I am the Rat's deck. Points but reveals your opponent's hand. Do I get like 20 provisions with that too? He's got some rats. Yeah, it's not that much value. Just information isn't worth that much. You need points. Doesn't matter if you know what your opponent's gonna do, if your opponent just plays more points than you. was it? That was real. Wee.